Whether you're new to using SOLIDWORKS or an advanced user with years of experience, it's important to maximize your hardware performance to improve efficiency. So, let's cut to the chase. Which graphics card should you buy? Well, if you're considering buying a new graphics card for a workstation running SOLIDWORKS, then we recommend Nvidia's Professional range. These cards are recommended for use with SOLIDWORKS as they come with supported graphics drivers and help to enhance the performance of SOLIDWORKS Visualize as well. Nvidia Professional graphics cards used to be known by the Quadro branding, but this changed back in 2021 with the release of Nvidia's Ampere generation of professional graphics cards. When choosing a graphics card, the key is to avoid Nvidia GeForce Gaming or consumer-grade cards, as these are not recommended for use with SOLIDWORKS. Instead, to identify Ampere generation cards, look out for the A prefix when researching card models. This convention has changed slightly since, with the introduction of the ADA generation. The RTX 2000, 3500, 4000, and 5000 ADA cards are some of our top recommendations. If you're doing less complex CAD work, or work with assemblies with a few hundred to a thousand parts, or only occasionally use SOLIDWORKS Visualize, then lower series numbers up to 2000 are suitable. But we believe the 3000 and 4000 series offer the best price to performance ratio and can easily handle more complex designs with many thousands of parts, more intense SOLIDWORKS Visualize use, 3D scan data, and more. At the higher end of the series, from 5000 and up, we see the most benefit when used for advanced SOLIDWORKS Visualize rendering, GPU-heavy computational workloads, and the most challenging of SOLIDWORKS datasets. Using a recommended graphics card is the single biggest boost you can give to your SOLIDWORKS performance. And if you aren't sure whether you're getting the most from your workstation or your SOLIDWORKS setup, then make sure you book an assessment with our development team, who will help you to maximize performance and optimize your design process so you can work more efficiently. Okay, so you've got a recommended graphics card, but is it set up for optimal performance? For desktop computers, and it will sound simple, the first thing to check is that all the monitors are plugged in correctly. This means ensuring that the monitors are plugged directly into the dedicated graphics card and not the onboard graphics included with the motherboard. For laptops with switchable graphics, check in on your Windows and Nvidia control panel settings to ensure that SOLIDWORKS is correctly using the dedicated graphics card. It's generally best to double-check these settings for other software applications as well. Before optimizing your SOLIDWORKS settings, make sure you're using the latest driver that your SOLIDWORKS version supports. You can find a full list of certified drivers via the link in the description. Hit the subscribe button while you're here, and be sure to check out our video guide to updating graphics card drivers and keep your system running smoothly. To optimize the performance of SOLIDWORKS, there are two main options in the performance section of the system options. Firstly, modern graphics cards can benefit hugely from turning on enhanced graphics performance. For this to take effect, SOLIDWORKS will need to be restarted. In SOLIDWORKS 2024 and beyond, you can also enable hardware acceleration for silhouette edges. This helps to improve the silhouette edge detail in hidden lines removed, hidden lines visible, and wireframe views. Beyond these, all the settings on this page impact performance in some way, but may depend more on your personal workflow. So experiment with them to see what works best for you. On the general settings page, show thumbnail graphics in Windows Explorer and enable freeze bar can be used to benefit your performance. The freeze bar is especially useful for halting rebuilds in complex parts with long feature trees. SOLIDWORKS drawings specifically have their own performance settings. Consider changing these settings for general performance improvements when working with 2D drawings, and consult your technical support team for further advice. For assemblies, most performance issues come from component rebuild times and the display of unnecessary details. Consider modifying some of these settings, or simplifying and defeaturing models as required. External references can also degrade performance if they force SOLIDWORKS to load the reference part. Changing this setting to prompt and unchecking search for external references can give some respite here. Animations may also put a strain on performance, so consider turning off zoom to fit when changing to standard views and moving transition sliders to off in the view settings. Finally, check that search indexing performance under the search settings is set so that indexing only occurs when the computer is idle. If you're looking to enhance the performance of specific files, then check in on the document properties. These are specific to each file, and changes can be saved to part, assembly, and drawing templates to allow newly created files to obey any changes. Modifying the image quality sliders can help improve performance for demanding files with lots of curved geometry. Just remember to push them back up before exporting the file for use in SOLIDWORKS Visualize. You can also try turning off Optimize Edge Length and improve curve quality at higher settings and evaluate performance. As we said, using a recommended graphics card is the single biggest boost you can give to your SOLIDWORKS performance. We also offer a wide range of Dell workstations available at great prices, so get in touch with us today to discuss your specific performance requirements via the details on screen.